Hello everybody. Today we're upgrading our internet. So over to Lewis.
This goes down to as thin as your hair.
Really?
Yeah.
That's fibre optic, is it?
Yep.
Australia's internet may have a bad reputation, perhaps unfairly, but today we're upgrading. We'll take you through the process, test the speeds, and also let you know why you should be thanking Australia for your internet wherever you are in the world. We'll also tell you how much our full optical fibre high-speed internet upgrade cost us. When we first moved to Australia, we actually thought the internet compared pretty well with the UK. Speeds were decent and we didn't have many issues, but lately it's been a completely different story. Our internet was slow, constantly cutting out, and our provider was no help. They were one of the two big telcos in Australia, and they just told us to turn it on and off again. We limped on for months and even tried hotspotting off our 5G mobiles, but that was just getting really expensive. We needed a long-term solution. So enough was enough, and last Friday I did an internet search and I found a company called Aussie Broadband. And guess what? They really seemed to listen. They recommended we get full fibre to our house, which we were eligible for. We place an order, and by Tuesday we had two NBN technicians ready to install the equipment at our house. That's just 3 days later. We have to say the NBN guys were just so helpful and professional. They asked us where we wanted our modem, and we said in our bedroom next to the old socket. They first ran a fibre optic cable from the street to a box they mounted on the wall of our house. So this has come from the road up to this point, and then it goes along the ceiling to our bedroom.
This goes down to as thin as your hair.
Really?
Yeah.
That's fibre optic, is it?
Yep. It was basically fibre to the node and then copper to your house.
Okay.
And now what you're going to be on is fibre all the way to your house.
So it's going to be really fast.
Yep.
And reliable.
Yep.
And you were saying our internet connection was just hanging on with a thread. It was very...
Yeah, no. It's rotten away.
This is our old internet connection. That's why it wasn't working properly.
Yeah, it just snapped.
Just snapped.
It must have been like, got chewed on or something, or corrosion.
It's been cutting out all the time.
Yeah, that's how thin it goes down here.
This is the fibre optic splicing, is it?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, we spliced down to 9 mils.
So you put a connector on the end of it.
Wow. Yeah.
So that cuts it, does it?
Yeah, cuts it straight.
Wow.
To precision. Have a little break.
Wow.
Right.
And then you test it with here, do you?
Yeah, it's the optical fiber rating. Mate, first time.
Let's see if we've got. Yep, beautiful.
Beautiful.
Got the
good job.
There.
Thank you.
Got a fucking there.
And it plugs into this other fiber once we wrap that one around.
And pop that in there.
Close the window that way.
There we go there.
So that's the fiber optic coming from the house into the ground.
Ah, that's correct, yeah. Oh, from the street.
From the street.
And from your room, that in there. Fibre to the premise.
Fibre to the premises.
Yeah, all fibre now.
Wow.
All the way
so,
to
so be so quick.
To your room, yeah.
So fibre to the node is what we had before, and then copper to
correct.
The house.
That's correct, yeah.
And all this upgrade is basically for free. The NBN, we haven't had to pay anything, so it's a really good...
That's correct.
Yeah, you can't complain about that.
That's right. Get up to a gigabyte per second.
Wow, a gigabyte per second, man.
Right.
Should be enough to you.
Down on maybe in 2 seconds.
So this just goes wraps around so it doesn't kink.
Yes.
NBN code. Awesome. going green. Is that a, that's a good sign, I guess?
Yeah, we've got to wait for the next lot to come on. Obviously, that's a good sign.
It's the access point, isn't it?
NTD.
NTD. What's that symbol?
Network termination.
Two lights, that's a good sign. It must be pleasing to see that.
Right, and everything.
All corroded.
That would have been
phone
dropped,
line.
That would have been dropped out too.
Yeah, this has been so unreliable.
Activate it now. And
we're just getting the service activated.
Yeah, and then you'll start seeing those lights flicker down. As soon as I walk out of here, you're about to use it.
Yeah. So the guys asked us where we wanted the box. We said in the bedroom, and it's been quite difficult for them to route the cable through the roof from the wall on the other side of the house, but they did it no problem. And it's all for free. Yeah. So you really can't complain about that. These are sort of ticks and boxes.
Yeah. About 20 to 30 seconds, you'll start seeing some lights flicker down there. Any second now. There you go.
Okay. Brilliant, so we've got internet.
Oh, yeah. Where's Aaron? Where's your modem? I'll plug it in for you.
Yeah, thank you. We bought a brand new modem. Thank you. So it plugs in.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See ya. We're going to run some speed tests. First of all, right next to the router in the bedroom. We're on a 100 megabytes per second plan, so anything over 100 is good. So it's 100 download, 15 upload, that's our plan. And we're over that. And now we're in the living room right next to the television. About the same as it was in the bedroom, so we've not lost anything. It's really quick. As I said before, we've paid for 100 upload, 15 download, so we're actually getting more than we've paid for. And there's more than enough for what we need. Okay, now we're outside. Exactly the same as before, we haven't lost any speed, which is pretty amazing. So this is the results for all the speed tests I've been doing around the house at different locations. We haven't seen any drop off in performance, which is pretty amazing. So even though the router's in the bedroom, we're not going to notice any speed difference anywhere in the house.
While we were talking about Wi-Fi, Australia played a massive role in two of the biggest breakthroughs in internet technology. Back in the early 90s, an Australian team at CSIRO, led by Dr. John O'Sullivan, was working on detecting tiny black holes in space. But in the process, they solved a problem that would change the world: how to send wireless signals without interference. And just like that, the foundation of modern Wi-Fi was born. Now, Wi-Fi powers everything. But wait, what about fast internet? That's where fibre optic technology comes in. While fibre optics weren't invented in Australia, Aussie physicist David Payne helped revolutionise the way we use them. His work on doped fibre amplifiers made it possible for fibre optic cables to carry high-speed internet over long distances without losing signal strength. Without it, you wouldn't have the fast, crazy internet speeds we rely on today. From Wi-Fi in your local cafe to high-speed fibre networks across the world, Australian innovation is at the heart of it all. We really love making these videos for you and we hope you enjoy watching them too. Thank you for watching. Lewis and Bonnie's Australian.